This video will explain how you can reassign functions to different controls by reconfiguring your command arm. Different operators often wish to have controls set for their personal liking. Different control settings may also be desired to make operation for different implements more efficient. In this video, we will also show you how you can save these settings in a profile for each operator or implement. At key on, first acknowledge any messages. Then touch the Control Setup button located on the navigation bar. When Control Setup page opens, each control and what functions it operates will be displayed. If you wish to build your own personal assignment, touch the Custom button. Now decide which controls you wish to reassign. For this example, we will reassign the number 6 SCV so that it will be controlled with the number 2 SCV control lever. To do this, we first touch the number 2 SCV to select it. Then touch Remove Assignment to remove the number 2 SCV assignment from this lever. Touch OK to confirm removal of this assignment. Now notice that the number 2 SCV control lever no longer has a function to control. Touch this number 2 control lever function area to add your new assignment. On the Select Functions page, scroll down to locate and then select the number 6 SCV. Notice now number 6 SCV is assigned to our number 2 control lever. However, also notice our number 6 control lever no longer has a function assigned to it. To assign it a function, we simply touch the number 6 function. We then locate and choose the number 2 SCV that was previously removed. Notice now number 2 SCV is now assigned to the number 6 control lever. Once all control levers are assigned to functions we desire, touch Save Load. Then touch Save Current Settings to save. A box then opens asking you to select settings you wish to save. Because these control lever assignments were reconfigured and are located on the command arm, we must place a check next to the command arm. Also, if settings were made to SCV flow and detent times on the SCV page of the command center, place a check next to SCV to save these settings. Likewise, if any changes were made on the transmission page or any other page of the command center, place a check next to those areas to save each setting. Then touch Save. You can then enter a name for this saved configuration. This will make it easier to locate and reuse next season when the same implement is connected. Touch OK to complete. Notice our custom settings are now saved as we had previously selected. Close the Control Setup page. Notice that our number 1 control lever controls the number 1 SCV, while the number 2 lever controls SCV 6. You are now ready to go to the field. After a key cycle, if custom settings were previously used, the operator is notified of the settings changes. This is accomplished by the Control Setup page being displayed. In addition, also notice the number 2 and number 6 control levers are grayed out. If the operator wishes to continue using these custom settings, simply touch the Custom button. Then close the Control Setup page. If, however, a different operator is using this machine, or tractor is connected to a different implement, controls can easily be set back to the factory default settings. Once the key is cycled on, you are again notified of the custom settings by the Control Setup page opening. Touch Defaults button to return tractor to the factory default settings. At restore control defaults, touch OK. Factory default settings are now restored on this tractor. Notice now, the number one SCV control lever controls SCV number one, number two controls SCV two, and number six now controls SCV number six. If at any time you wish to change back to one of your previously saved custom settings, touch the control setup button on the navigation bar. Touch save load. Select your previously saved custom settings and then touch OK. Touch settings selected to choose all previously saved pages. Then touch OK. Once settings are loaded, touch OK. Your previously saved configurations are now available. Close the control setup page to return to tractor run page.